Morning students, today I am going to take chapter polynomials subtopic remainder theorem. We have already sent you the video of remainder theorem and factor theorem. I hope the topic is clear with you. I'll just give a quick reminder of the remainder theorem. Let's revise the remainder theorem. The remainder theorem says that if a polynomial, say p of x, is divided by another polynomial which is linear, then we obtain a remainder without actually going for the division, long division. So what we do is, let me first revise the long division and then we'll take the remainder theorem. Now if I take a polynomial p of x, that is x square plus 7x plus 13, whose degree is greater than 1. Here the degree is 2, which is greater than 1. This is our requirement of the remainder theorem, that the degree of the polynomial should be greater than or equal to 1. Now degree, you know, is the highest power of the variable. So now if it is divided by a linear polynomial, say x plus 3, this is the way we go for the long division. And the remainder comes out to be 1. So instead of going for long division, we have a method given by the remainder theorem. In this method, what we do is, we find the zero of the divisor. You know how to find the zero of the divisor? We put the divisor equal to 0. The value of x comes out to be minus 3. Now put the value minus 3 in the given polynomial, say that is p of x. So when you put the value, it is p of minus 3. Wherever x is there, there you put minus 3. So on calculating, I get the value as 1. Now this 1 here is called the remainder, and it is verified through the long division also that the remainder is same, that is 1. So instead of going for long division, what we do is, we find the 0 of the divisor, substitute the 0 in the given polynomial, that becomes the remainder. This is the statement of the remainder theorem. Now from the book, let us read the statement. It says that, let p of x be any polynomial whose degree is greater than or equal to 1 and a is any real number. Then, if p of x is divided by a linear polynomial of the type x minus a, here a is a real number. You know, real number means it could be a rational or an irrational number. So, if it is divided by a linear polynomial of a type x minus a, then the remainder is given by p of a. Here, how to get this remainder? You find the 0 of the divisor, 0 aata a, and put the value of a here. So, p of a becomes the remainder. I hope the remainder theorem is clear to you. Thank you.